my gosh. Thank you all for showing up.
Hey, everybody. Hi, video.
There you go.
Hi, everyone. How's it going? I hope everybody's great. Yay, I'm so excited. People are excited to be here. This is wonderful. And I think we'll just get this show on the road and we'll let people jump in as they join us. And obviously this video will go on our website a little later. And so I just wanted to welcome everybody to our authenticity and self-belief webinar. I think it's gonna be a fun one. And I'll let Shawn kind of say, well, you already said hi, didn't you?
I'm on a little chat box here right now. I'm like,
really quick.
I want to say hello to everybody at the moment, but let me just say, yeah, I absolutely want to say a big shout out, big hello, a big extension of gratitude for your being here for you, which is the biggest thing of all. This is about you. This is for you. And I want you to know this is just not like a webinar. It's probably just going to be a live. We should call it live because we're clearly live. But we want this to be engaging. We want to engage with all of you. So if you got questions and if we say something, certainly you can raise your hand. Or if I'm talking, Ari will be on looking at the chats. Or if she's talking, I'll be looking at the chats. And if you have a specific question, by all means, hit the chat box and we'll try and get to it. 100% try and get to it. So I want to say thank you again so much for showing up. Authenticity and self-belief. We're going to cover believing in yourself. What is authenticity? What does that mean? How do we do it? How do we get it? And what really, what's the biggest thing that's blocking us? What is it? I can tell you right now, it's not out there. It's right in here. It starts with limiting beliefs. That is the source of it. So as many of you know, of course, we're actors. So we're both creative artists and creative life coaches. So that's really the genesis. People are like, wow, I thought you guys were on TV. And we are, beautifully, thankfully enough. But we're like, we got to do more. We got to do more, especially when COVID hit. We were sitting up there in our little treehouse like, babe, How do we connect? Nothing. No, the productions aren't going on. Days isn't on at the moment. And clearly it still was running. But we were like, no, how do we connect and reach more people? And we started with our why. And we're going to get into it. Ari's going to get into it. I'm just giving you a little setup here for the moment to let you know, for those of you, if this is your first time, if you're like, well, who are you two? I don't get it. We have spent over 20, 30 years creating the life we imagine, both on screen and off. And that is something we all can do. We are the creators of our own lives. But what are you going to choose to create? That's up to you. And is it coming from you? So that's what we're going to get into. And if you're not, trust me, we've all been there. I'll share a little story after Ari speaks a bit about this is one of the biggest challenges I've gone through. Finding my authentic voice. Where do I fit in? What is authentic? How do I do it? Not easy. We're all there. We've all been there. So just so you know, everybody here, thank you. I see more people signing on, which just absolutely rocks. So thank you so much. Christopher, I see you. Yes, Father Fred, big shout out. So thank you again, everybody. Deeply, deeply grateful for you showing up. Again, this is engaging. We don't want to talk at you. We want to engage with you. So please, please, you got questions, thoughts, bring them to the forefront. That's what we're here for. All right, I'll get more into that a little bit, but I'll let Ari talk because I can go on and I'm going to just go. So you take it away, babe.
Thank you so much for that. That was like, dove right in. He was like,
I got more. I'm like, oh boy. Yes.
No, it's great. And I think, you know, for people popping on, and like you said, you know, people may not know us, you might be coming on for the first time, or you might just want to know, you know, why and what we're doing. So that's a little bit what I want to explain just to start is I've been in the entertainment business myself for 25 years, and I have always, always, always wanted to enrich and enlighten my life. I've been that way since I was a little girl. And what's so interesting in my life experiences along the way, and I think this is really important because it's always important to share that you always are continuing to learn. You're always continuing to change. And I have had an amazing journey with life coaches, with therapists, with spiritual guides. And what's interesting is every single one of those coaches and teachers and therapists that I met with had asked me, have you ever thought of being a therapist, a mentor, a coach yourself? And I'm like, no, I still have to fix me. So, you know, you don't think that you have this. And then I'm thinking back going, now wait a second. I have been volunteering since I can remember. I really started out with Make-A-Wish, moved into Habitat for Humanity, helping families build their home with sweat equity. Then I'm skipping a lot of other organizations that I worked with, but then started my own nonprofit with my brother called Arrow Heart Adventure Camps. And we help teens find their true nature in nature. Thank you, Sean Christian, for that tagline. He is the one that came up with that. But it's so I've realized I've constantly found a way to give back and help others. And now we are really compartmentalizing it into this life coaching. And what I realized I'm really good at, and I don't know if this fits you, is I am really great at emotional development. I took a 2-year emotional development course. I can teach you how to sit with your emotions, how to understand your emotions, and how to change your emotions with just a thought. And I'll leave it next to you, Sean, because I know you had something special you want to talk about authenticity off the bat. Right. And then we'll get into the self-belief portion.
For sure. That's exactly it. That is one of the things that, as I explained, we've been trained to do. And of course, life sort of trained you as one of the best schools of all in using the power of your own thought to change how you feel, to change what you believe. So physically, and even neuroscientists say you can genetically start to change your whole body, even with a thought, a very thought. Just the way, you know, look, if I sat like this and be like, okay, my whole energy just shifted my thought right there. Now, if I literally put my shoulders back, I got my shoulders up, I could put my hands on my hip or whatever. And now I feel you, and you, well, you can do this at home if you want. By all means, what's happening here? Get in your body. It's attached to your mind. And your mind is clearly attached to your thoughts. But just so you know, and I'll go over this again, we are not our minds. We are not defined by our bodies. There's that thing in between that you can't see. It's called a soul. We are that. That is unique. That is something each and everyone has, something really unique and special. And that's essentially why we do what we do, certainly as artists and as life coaches, because it is helping and inspiring, empowering you, people, to use their unique gifts to create. What are you going to create? The most meaningful and biggest impact on other people's lives. So we're inspiring to inspire you, to inspire others. That's it. And the world is a better place for it. It's a wonderful place. That is exactly how I narrow down how and why I do what I do and what I'm about. Clearly, I've gotten lost on the path. I can share a lot of that. But I'm telling you, when COVID hit, I was like, wow, I can't get on the stage. I can't. No film's happening right now. Nothing. Well, that's not going to stop me. I'm not going to sit still and do nothing. It's not in my true nature. Of course, so I go out in nature and we hike and we think and we meditate and pray, all the good stuff, and we just get connected to us. Go, what are we doing? Why are we doing what we're doing? It's enriching, inspiring, empowering, energizing, elevating, and enlightening the world within us and the world around us. I said this before. That's it. And as life coaches, when we're feeling alive and we're in that zone, I'm like, and people don't have it. And we're talking with clients and people, you're like, and they're like, how do I get there? How do I get there? But their path is different. It's unique. Everybody has something so special, so unique within them, but it's blocked half the time. And we're not reaching our full potential. There's an amazing quote by Albert Einstein. It's about genius. Everybody has genius, right? But if you judge a fish by its ability to climb a tree, it will live its entire life believing it is stupid. Think about that. If you judge a fish by its ability to climb a tree, it will live its life believing it's stupid. It's a fish. It swims. It doesn't climb a tree. But we got to know who we are. We can't get to be what we want to be unless we know, like, first of all, where are we at? One of my biggest challenges. I had been a small town boy from Chicago, not a small town boy. I'm a boy from a small town in Michigan, but that's who I am. It's my DNA, right? I'm like, no, I want to do other things. I want to be an actor. I want to change the world and impact people's lives. Okay, great. I'm going to move to Chicago. And I'm like, wow, this is different. Wow. Okay. People dress different. They talk a little different. This is okay. Wow. How do I kind of fit in here? How do I make this work? And I sort of altered a little bit who I am. It's okay to grow and expand by all means. It's a big difference. But I can categorically tell you some of the biggest mistakes in my life, the root cause of them, you know what it is? I wasn't true to myself. I tried to be what other people wanted me to be or what I thought they thought I should be. And I abandoned that. And that's where we get off track. Some of the biggest challenges in my life can really go right back to that. It wasn't me. I was trying to be something else. When I go to New York, I'm trying to fit in there. Well, this is different. And I go to LA, I'm trying to be everything to everybody, right? I have been blessed to be on the screen in like over 50 roles, different films, television, whatever. But one of the things, and I've been blessed to do it, love it, love immersing myself into another soul, another character, if you will. But what happened? I didn't spend the same amount of time cultivating my authentic truth. I spent a lot of time being in other characters, but not a lot of time being myself. And we have to be. That is it. We got a list of being. Like you have to go, what do I want to be? A lot of times, like, well, what can I do to change my life? What can I have? First of all, well, what's my goal? I'm going to have this. Great. What do I got to do? Then I got to just be this. Have, do, be. Flip that upside down. Be it first. Be you, ultimately. And we'll talk about this later in the webinar. How do you get to be you? What is that going to take? Right? It's about your own belief system. And for me to find myself, what did I have to do? And any of us have to do. We got to be real. How do we be real? What is that? How do you do that? Got to be real with yourself. You got to be honest with yourself. And you got to be clear with what excites you, what makes you come alive. And that's what we're here to talk about. I can get going on this, but I just want you to know everybody out there, each one of you has a unique gift. But getting through the blockages and the limiting beliefs of what we're told we're supposed to be from peers, teachers, sometimes parents, sometimes coaches, teachers, or the bad kid on the playground told us that one thing. And we believe it today. And I'm like, well, why aren't I living the life I imagine? I don't understand. Well, because some kid told you were this and now you believe it to some degree. Those are blocks. So we'll get into that. So again, I'm going to pass this along to Ari a little bit. And I'll come back. She's got some great ideas also on thoughts and meditations, if you will, on beliefs. Again, if you got questions, I'll be to kind of scrolling through the chat box. But I love that you're engaged and I love that you're with us. So again, much gratitude. All right. Up to you.
And we're done. No, I'm
kidding. Well, we're not done. I'm
kidding.
With that. One hour. I'm like, no, slow down.
Yes. Well, I think the best thing is to sort of what you just left off with our belief system is that our belief system is something that is learned, right? Our belief system is not something naturally we're born with. It is something that our parents teach us, much like Shawn said, your mentors, your coaches, your friends, any congregation that you might, attend, all these things are put on you, right? And then you get to a certain point in your life where you have the ability to create your beliefs and what is important for you. But what's interesting is even every belief that you gain, every value that you put on your belief comes with a fear. It comes with a worry. It is a natural thing when we put value on something, it comes with a negative because that is how we process things, right? And what happens with that is it disconnects us from our higher self. It disconnects us from our authenticity because it makes us feel like we've got to hold on to that value, because that value is so important. That thing, that belief system I have is so, so important to me. I can't lose it. And it's so important. And I'm not just talking about, you know, belief is just a faith thing. I am talking about whatever your family values are, whatever your, those are your belief systems, right? Your work ethic. These are all belief systems, right? And so I just want to make sure that I'm very clear on there anything that you set that has a standard in your life. And so the, I won't get into authenticity yet. I got a little excited there. But so we want to learn how to have our authenticity first and then connect our belief system. Because it's really hard to find your authenticity when we have a lot of fears attached to it. So what happens is belief has attachments. Authenticity is about removing your attachment. It's about being okay with you, about sitting with yourself and being accepting where you are with fear and with doubt and with worry, so that you can eventually remove that and find your true authentic self. And then add your belief system in, because you're going to have a whole new outlook on how to see your beliefs. And I know that can sound confusing because it's really quite deep. And so there's pros and cons to our belief system, right? And all our pros are all the wonderful things. And I'm just going to reiterate kind of what I just said, just in case that didn't, you know, if I'm going too fast or if that's not making sense. But there's our pros for our belief system, which is all the positives. And then there's our cons. For instance, there's a lot of group thinking and beliefs, right? We can take a sorority or a fraternity or a math group or a cheerleading squad or, you know, your work, however you want to call it. And there's a type of group thinking, right? There's rules, there's relationships, there's all these things that we have to handle as we move into our society, right, with groups. But what we want to be careful about is not attaching ourselves to group thinking. And I think Shawn mentioned this earlier, it's about fitting in. We don't want to fit in, we want to lead. So when you find your authentic self and you go into the group setting, you automatically already have a leadership vibe, a loving vibe. I know who I am, which is an attractive energy. And it's finding that true, authentic energy in your belief system. Anybody have any questions on that yet? Because I know that can be that. So you see the pattern is.
That's so good, yeah.
Right? Removing the belief system that creates a fear-based belief system. Finding your true, authentic self. So you recreate the belief system with confidence, with truth, and with love.
That's a great one. Listen, I'll cabbage onto that a little bit, because I think one of the biggest biggest obstacles, and one of the biggest obstacles to authenticity, is our mind. And as I said earlier, we're not our mind. We think we're our mind, so we think we're our thoughts. So whatever I think, I believe that's what I am. And we just get tied up into that. And you know what most people on the planet think and believe? I'm not enough. Everybody, some of the biggest artists, biggest athletes, politicians, anybody, you talk to anybody, they've had a bout with, I'm not enough, and they'll still have it again. I have it, I've had it, I'll still have it. They're like, oof, am I enough? I'll keep pushing, I'll keep trying. But I'm not judging and being critical with myself. Because I know I'm not my thoughts. And if I don't like it, if it's not giving me the outcome that I want, my authentic self, then I know my lifestyle is not in alignment.
John, I have a good question for you.
Yeah.
That I wrote down is, what does good enough look like?
Well, yeah, I'll tell you, and that's what I'll get to that, because it's absolutely true. It's good enough. It has something unique about everybody. But if we let other people's define what we feel is good enough, we're just crumbling, we're crushing. We're like, why are we so upset? What's happening? Why are we not feeling and living our authentic life? Why are we not alive? What's happening? Why aren't we there? right? And a mind, as I said, and we do this as I said, a profession, has the capacity and the ability to create anything. But the mind also has the ability to destroy. And if you're thinking about destructive, negative thoughts, you're destroying the moments that you've been blessed with. And we get in, all of us, we go through it, we get through that vicious cycle, right? And when we feel we're not enough, what's happening? What's really going on? What's the root of that? When we're not feeling appreciated, we're not feeling loved. We're not enough. When we're enough, guess what happens? We feel loved. People love us. We love ourselves because we're like, no, I'm enough. I'm enough in this moment. I'm holding space in this moment. I don't have to agree with you. I don't have to fit in with you. I don't have to believe what you believe. I have my own sense of values and virtues because how did I get there though? I've reflected on it. But when we get that love, when we know we're enough, love is like oxygen. It's just, we just breathe. It would just, I mean, we all feel it, right? When you feel loved, you just can breathe better. You move better. You're upright. You're happy. You bounce. There's a bounce in your step. The opposite of that, when we're not getting the love, like, oh, we're losing that oxygen, right? And then you get to the root of that. It's like, well, where's the love? Well, I don't know. I'm not enough. Just not, why aren't you enough? I don't fit in, right? And I'll tell you, here's a little small list of the blockages that get in our way of our, and these are the limiting beliefs. And this is what happens, gets in the way of living our authentic life, right? Shame, self-worth, big one, by the way. Vulnerability, fear, comparison, judgment. And that big one, everybody wants to do it. I want to fit in. I want to belong. And you quite often do it at the expense of your own truth. So let's unpack that a little bit. What is it? Okay, great. We get it. So what is it going to take? Some good questions coming in. What is it going to take? What do we got to do? First of all, we have to awaken to ourselves. We have to wake up and go, whoof, with the clear intention of going, I just need to know myself. I need to spend time with myself. A lot of the clients we talk, we work with, they're not spending time with, how much self-love do you give in a given day? Don't do it. I don't have time for that. And I get it. Non-judgment call. I get those times in the day. I'm like, dang, did I take time out to love myself? Some sense of self-care, some affirmations about what I believe about me. And that is that B list. And write this down. What is my B list? What do I want to be? I want to be inspiring. I want to be creative. I want to be loving. I want to be compassionate. I want to be caring. I want to be empathetic. I want people to grow. I want to grow. I got to be these things to live in the world that I want to live in, the world that I want to create. That thought. If I'm not having these thoughts, I'm not believing these things, I'm not living in this belief system, I'm not living the life I desire, right? But if I'm believing I'm stupid, or let's say a first grade teacher said, oh, you're never going to, dude, acting's what? No, you're not going to be an actor. That's crazy. Crazy people aren't, you're no, it's not going to happen. You're not creative. I can tell you, here's an example. I'm sure everyone has a story, by the way, of somebody who told them something when they were a kid and they felt that they were good at something and said, or compared themselves to somebody. Like, I love to create and draw, right? I just loved art, just creating. And then I remember there was one day I was drawing and I looked over at the kid next to me and he was so good. He did characters, like he could draw me, you, Ari, whatever. And you go, wow, okay, I suck as an artist. I'm not good. So I was like, and then she's like, can I see your paper? I'm going to do math, whatever. I don't know. Right. But we have these creative scars that we live with today. Huge percentages of people don't believe they can create. They don't, because they compare themselves to somebody who, oh, that person can create. Yeah. That person. Yeah. Oh God, they have it. Well, what is it about those people that we admire? And you go, bang, they're in the zone. They're living that life. I want to live that life. You comparing? Well, I want that. I want this and that. You want things? What do you want? What do you need to be? What do you want to be? You have to unpack that. So you awaken yourself to yourself. What does that take? I say meditation, and we talked about this in our mindfulness webinar. It's not always sitting at home. Oh, and you talk to everybody who's trying to meditate. They're like, I hate this. I keep thinking about the dinner that needs to be cooked, or the job, or the something that didn't get done, right? But the idea of meditation is not the fact that your mind's distracted. You train your mind to bring yourself back to yourself without judgment. Don't judge. You're just spending time. It's so hard for most people. It really is. It's easier to just kind of put on the mask and let me just kind of fit in. It's easier. It's less painful. Unless you're sacrificing something that's important to you. And then it is. I've been there. It costs so much. It really does. Depending on to the extent that you sacrifice your own truth, your own beliefs, it can hurt. I've been there. I'm not gonna lie. But I learn, I grow, which is why you're all here. You're here to learn, you're here to grow, and more importantly, get in touch with you. And I'll tell you that here's the definition of authenticity. I have to really, right? Just to really, just to get some clarity about what is authenticity. Easy for me to say. I'm trying to bring it here in the light. Okay, authenticity is the degree to which a person's actions are congruent with their beliefs and desires. Here's the good part. Despite external pressures to conformity, right? Authenticity, are your actions congruent, consistent with your beliefs, with your desires, despite what the world tells you you should be doing? We thwart ourselves so easily by one comment. Social media, huge thing, right? We'll go through a feed or whatever, so much love and you're great, great. But what do? We focus on that one comment. I don't know, I can't believe you're so arrogant or whatever the thing is. And we're what? We obsess on the negative thought. And now we start to adopt, like, what's wrong with me? Well, how come this person didn't like me? Another huge thing I had to learn and go through. You know, I want people to like me. Like, wait, what? Because I'm not being me, right? So we all have BS. We all live with BS, by the way. Okay, just so you know. The BS is a choice, though. Is it the BS? I'm going to say it. Or is it your true belief system? Because we all have BS. But what is our BS? Are we kidding ourselves? Are we feeding ourselves a story? What's the story we're telling ourselves? Is it ours? Is it even ours? Or is it somebody else's? Big epiphany. When you realize and you go, wait, my thoughts are my own. And when I let that person control me with a thought, I've given away all my power. All my authentic divine power that you're blessed with, every one of us. Unique, our life experiences have shaped us to be so special, so unique. And it makes my heart sad when I see people crumble. And they're allowing other people to their thoughts and opinions to control what is so beautiful inside. They've given it away. Have a conversation with your 90-year-old self, 100-year-old self, whatever, on your deathbed once. What should have I done? What would I have done? What could I have done differently? In my experience, most people, when they have that conversation with their older self, it's not about what they regret doing. It's what they regret not doing. And the root of that is being true to yourself and others. As I mentioned before, why do I do what I do? Is helping and empowering, inspiring people to use their unique gifts to create the most meaningful and biggest impact on other people's lives.
And there's a couple questions. You were on such a great roll, but I want to interject.
No, I've been chatting.
You know, first of all, just stepping back a little bit, just on a comment Audrey made, was when she grew up in foster care. Thank you for sharing that, by the way. She grew up in foster care and was told that she'd never be a great parent because her parents basically left her you know, there, right? Am I saying that correctly? Let me just double check. She wouldn't be a good mom because her parents were not wanting me. And it took her years to realize that that's not true, right? And I guarantee some of that stuff sits with you in other belief systems. You know, we have a tendency to still hold on to those things and really work on not allowing those words. I'm doing a podcast specifically on understanding words coming up, but it goes with your belief system of going, that belief system doesn't apply to me anymore. I have another, another question that says, like, you know, how do I, why do I struggle? I'm struggling. And I how do I understand why that happens and why I can't feel, like you were saying, Shawn, why I can't get away from it and why those words continue to press on you. And that is the thought process that we really, really, our work as life coaches is that is the one thing that we pride ourselves on, the work of shifting your thought, because by allowing your negativity to take your power away, to take your belief, your authenticity away, because it really ends up what you're doing, you're allowing that negativity to take your power and to not let you, you're not allowing yourself to not believe it anymore. That's why it keeps happening. So as simple as, you know, I was telling you before, I'm really good at flipping the emotion, flipping the thought, you have a thought, makes you have an emotion, it makes you act and makes you react, right? Your result is never that great because you're so busy reacting to a negative result. So you can take someone, let's just a small example, go, wow, really irritates me the way you eat. Well, instead of being irritated, don't be irritated. It's a very simple example and it takes a lot of work to get there. But this is how powerful our thought process is. I want to take that question right there. All these questions kind of go together. How do you deal with people who are better than you when you have negativity? If I'm understanding that question right, no one's better than you. People can be better at understanding the process of how to handle their thoughts. We are all amazing. And the more we sit with those emotions and the more we understand that we are amazing and we are gifted, that's those negative thoughts you can shift. It takes work. We're not going to fix this. We're not going to fix the questions in one night. But if we can get you to understand the importance of the meaning of somebody else's words and you allowing someone to take that power away, which was Shawn so eloquently said, is you're allowing that person to take the power, make you feel negative, and now you feel defeated. Instead of going, I'm pretty sure you're saying that because you're the one that feels negative. You're the one that feels stinky. It's usually why people say things is because they are fearing something. So when you can look at a person who says something negative, and if I say to Shawn, I can say this two ways to Shawn, and he's gonna take it two different ways, right? Or he can just ignore it and say, I love you. He's gonna have one response. We can go, I love you. And he can take the second one and go, she's really mad right now. And that does no reflection on me. Because when you know that your truth, when you find your authentic self, going back to authenticity and your self-belief, when you understand your authenticity, your true self and who you are and the love you have for you, when you are the one, when you fall in love with yourself again, that is when it doesn't matter what somebody else says, because you understand that person must be going through something because I know I'm a very good person. Yes, things happen. We make mistakes. Absolutely. If you're not a vindictive person who goes out to purposely hurt people, most of us have a lot of beautiful truth in us, and we need to just find it and sit with it and understand that all the things in the world that happen on the outside are not because of us. And things happen for us, not to us. They happen for us to teach us how to handle a situation. We have a couple ways to handle it. We're going to handle it in a proactive way, or we're going to handle it in a negative way. And the choice is up to you. It may not be a great choice, but I definitely choose the positive. Because we always have a choice. The why me and why is it happening to me? Why, you know, those questions are, it's not happening to you. It's happening for you. So you can better understand. You write down, wait a minute, this happened today and I didn't really like how it happened. And I didn't really like how I reacted. And I'm going to write this down and I'm going to start to understand, well, gosh, I really didn't like how that lady looked at me at the grocery store, or she was rude. Well, maybe she had something tragic happen to her that day. And it's us, you know, as human beings, to sort of start getting outside ourselves and opening ourselves up more, to allow ourselves an understanding when it comes to communication, because we're losing that communication with people. It's a very chaotic time right now, and we all can see it, and the weight is very, very heavy. So to change that to the positive, you be the positive, I be the positive, Shawn gets to be the positive, we get to be the light for those who are struggling, having a hard time. I think I'm hoping I answered a couple of those questions of the why.
Yeah, yeah. There's some really great questions. Yeah. Karen, I see your question, and you're not alone, by the way, and nobody else. I'm going to bounce on to Bonnie a minute. I'm going to get back to Karen on that thought, because this is an interesting question, and Viva struggle with this a lot. So how do you deal with people who, and you just said this, by the way.
Yeah, I did.
I just want to ask you this, Bonnie, right? You came in, you asked this question. It's a great question. How do you deal with people who are better than you? Who said they're better than you? It's my first question, okay? Not a judgment. But when you get to the root of where that came from, you're onto something now. This is what we do in our life coaching. It takes time. It doesn't happen in a webinar or even a lot of time, because we have to unpeel the layers of, well, where did this come from? So Bonnie, and this is something I truly, like, who said that you're better? You go, well, I can tell. I can tell they're better than me. Okay. Why is that? What is, do they have fancier clothes? Do they have a better job? Right? Yeah, the list can go on, right? But then we get to the root of why we develop this limited belief that someone, in fact, indeed, is better than us. Trust me, everybody struggles with all these things we're talking about. I don't care if they ride a Lamborghini and have a mansion in Malibu. I'm telling you, everyone struggles with these. It's such a common human condition. It's different ways. It's all right. But first of all, the question starts with comparison. So you're comparing your value based on somebody else. So you just assume, based on whatever belief system you're adopting, that they indeed are better than you. Comparison is very toxic. We do it on social media. We do it at our workplace. We do it with family members and, you know, people we have to encounter on a daily basis. Oh my God, they're so much better than me. And I'm always curious as to, why do you believe that? Well, they're making money and they have a boat or a car or whatever. I don't know. Who said that makes that better, right? Because I'm telling you, Bonnie, there's something inside of you that's so unique and so special. I'm not just spitting this out during a webinar. I believe it. But it doesn't matter if I believe it. You have to believe it. And you have to build that, a value system. What do you value? What do you hold dear? Are your actions in alignment with what you believe? So you're like, well, they're better than me, so I'm going to behave like they're better than me. So you're living that lane. You believe someone's better than you, so consequently, you're going to behave. Your actions are consistent. You're just, right? But if you believe, no, I am who I am. But what does that take? That's the big question. And I'm going to get to also the same with Karen. Huge. And let me just say this for your questions. I appreciate your vulnerability. Most people are scared to be vulnerable. And what does vulnerability entail? Being real. Right? It's okay to just go, wow, I'm just not good at this, whatever it is. But now with a critical mind, with a compassionate mind, and you may go, okay, well, how do I get to be better at that? Why do I want to be better at it? Why is a huge deal? But affirmations. So once you build these pillars, so how do we start building our sense of authenticity? First of all, letting go of what other people think. Letting go. I'm telling you, this is something I had to learn. I was like, I go to an audition or I meet somebody. I'm like, what did they think? What did they think of me? I think Oprah said this, by the way. Every guest, no matter, I don't care who it is, big, you know, Oprah meets all the best, right? The one question everyone asks her at the end of the interview, was that good enough? Everyone. We all feel it differently. It doesn't make them better or worse. We all have that sensation, but it's okay. What are we going to do with that? That is gold. When you approach it with the idea of like, this is an opportunity for me to grow. This is an opportunity for me to build my sense of self-worth. When you see everything as an opportunity, everything you see is an opportunity. So the fact that you're asking this question is, this is just the tipping point. You're vulnerable enough. You're cracking the shell. You're taking the mask off and you go, you know what? I don't feel good enough. I feel like that person's better than me. That's raw. That's real. And what did I say at the beginning? How do we tap into authenticity? We got to be real with ourselves first. And then we got to get clear about what excites us. Us. Not to impress, but what truly makes us feel alive? What is it? And you're going to start, once you uncover that and you sit and you reflect. And Christopher, you asked some great questions here about my belief system and my BS. What is my B list? Right? You're asking me what your B list is. I love your curiosity, by the way, Christopher. Don't stop being curious. I love it. Keep going, everybody. Stay curious. But I can't tell you what your B list is. That takes something deep within inside you. I can certainly help and guide, inspire, and empower. And this is what we do with our clients because it's their journey. It's not our journey. If I get time, I'll pull up the difference between what a therapist does, what a consultant does, what a coach does, compared to what a coach does, right? It's a really kind of cool thing in a way. But the idea being that list is yours. And it's awesome, but it's okay that we don't have clarity at the moment. But what does it take to get clarity? Self-reflection and sharing it with someone. Look, this is what we are as a life coach. We're accountability partners, right? We're not here and you're here. We're in this together with our clients, helping you be the best you, uncovering the unique gifts that your B-list. We got to clear out these limited beliefs that we've been taught. They're in there and they're so unconscious, we're not even aware of it. It's like we're in the car, but we're not even driving the vehicle. Someone else is, based on what they've told us. We're not even driving our own car. Consequently, we're not even driving our own life. We just give the wheel to you. Oh, you're better than me. Take the wheel. And you're just hanging on for dear life. And you look back 5-10 years from now, you're like, wait. I lived my life based on this belief that someone who doesn't even know my heart, by the way, that's why the vitriol sometimes on social media, and you know, you're trying to tear people down and 145 characters, it just doesn't make sense. And we take that to heart. We allow. It's a big deal because we're allowing people to control our authenticity. We give it away freely, daily, which leads me to another strategy that it's going to take to find your authenticity: daily practice. You have to practice this daily because the world is out there. They're ready to tell you all sorts of things. We all know it, right? You have to find that self-love, that self-care, that time, daily practice, affirmations. We work with this with clients all the time. Right. And sometimes you'll go, well, you know, I'm loyal, I'm kind, I'm trustworthy, I'm friendly, I'm a good coworker, I'm a good parent, I'm a good mother, I'm a good son, I'm good, whatever. Okay. Do you believe that? Well, yeah. Why? Well, you got to get to the action. What are you doing that proves that you are this human being? This person, what are you being in the world, right? What are you being? And you practice that daily. And when we talk about these affirmations and you go, look, I am worthy enough. Karen, I don't care if you get all sticky note and you just put it on your right above your bed or on your mirror in the morning, I am worthy of love and respect. And you say that to yourself and you repeat it, right? And it's not just a sticky note, because we have to believe it in our body, mean it in our mind, and feel it in our heart over and over and over. That takes time and that takes practice.
Sean.
Go ahead.
I want to get to just because we're getting.
Get to them. Yes, please.
And Audrey asked another good question.
Yeah.
That I'm going to read it so that I read it correctly. How often do you feel your authentic self changes? And this is such a great question because it's not how often you feel it, it's that you start to be it. And this is such a great comparison with understanding your gut feeling and what you, that's your intuition. Having a wish, like, oh, I wish I could change. I wish my life can change. I want my life to change. It's your gut knowing that you have. So much like Sean's talking about that self-love and letting go and really starting to journal and write down the things that are so that bother you so much. And then write down how you think that you can change it. How you can shift your thought process to something positive and start finding that love for yourself. Because as you start to, when you physicalize and you start to write things down, you're focusing and you're physicalizing change. So the negativity allows you to, you allow to sit with the negativity. When you recognize what the negativity is, this is what I really wanted to say. When you really understand by asking that question right there, you're that much closer to your authentic self because now you're addressing it. And when you address your fear and you understand what it is, it starts to dissipate. And the more you talk about it or the more you write it down, the more you have an understanding for it. And you allow that fear, it no longer becomes an issue because it can't hide in you anymore. Because you're facing it straight on, going, okay, fear, okay, negativity, I see you now, and I'm starting to understand what you do to me, and I'm not gonna allow it anymore. I'm gonna get rid of you. You can even have that conversation with yourself, so it allows you to really, to get to that place where it no longer bothers you, where it's no longer a button. Because we have these buttons or we have these layers that were this light underneath and we've got all these blankets all over us. And it's fear and anger and sorrow and disparity. And we have to pull all of them off slowly, one by one, step by step. And that is that those many steps closer to your authentic self, which you will start to feel. By allowing yourself to sit with those emotions and get it out of your system by writing it down. For each and every little thing that bothers you or makes you feel negative, or the words that someone says to you, find some time to write that down and start removing it from your body. It's like exercising your negativity. No, exercise your some negativity. Like to find some humor in it so that you can start to laugh and start to love and find the excitement in your life again, because that is also really, really important. It's finding that joy and finding that love and finding like, hey, I'm doing it. Oh my gosh, I'm getting rid of my negativity. It's amazing. Because we don't want everything to be so heavy all the time, because it already is in our life. So how do you allow yourself to find the humor in your negativity as well, which is all, that's a form of love too, right, for yourself. So I hope that answered that question. Actually, Yolanda, Shawn had a really great question also as well. I'll read that to you. Yeah, do you see it?
Back. Yeah, go ahead.
Yeah. We have a few more minutes, so we want to make sure we get these in.
How do we check our power back, that one?
Yes, that's Yolanda's, yeah.
Yeah, from how do we take our power back from this toxic negativity and grow away from it? Choice. You have the power. You have to believe you have the power. You can choose to give it away, or you can choose to own it and own our story. That's where authenticity comes from. We got to own our story, but we have to know our story. So it takes time. Reflect on your story. What am I about? Me, what do I love? What excites me? What can I create in the world to make the world a better place? When we have meaning and purpose and service, when we serve, studies show we feel better about who we are. We do. It's human nature. I don't think anybody would disagree. When we give and we share and we see the feelings that we can arouse in someone, it gives us a wonderful feeling. And we do it truthfully, honestly, with integrity, honor, and dignity. Man. Big, big difference. And now, as we close this up, you know, one of the things, as I said, choice, that was another third thing to do. You can choose. Not easy, but when you value your authenticity over the opinions and thoughts of others, no one's going to shake it. They'll try and crack that sense of self-worth, as Karen was talking about. We have to build that. What makes me feel a sense of self-worth? What is it? Why am I putting that sticker up that says I'm worthy of love and respect, kindness? Or I'm an amazing mother. I'm an amazing coworker, whatever. Why are we worthy of that? And what actions can I take because to make myself worthy of that? Because that's who I want to be. But you have to get that list. What do I want to be? Be, do. And then you'll have authenticity and you'll have a lot of other things as well. Right? But another thing that authentic people do, they are able to talk to themselves. People who are truly authentic have the capacity to have this great conversation with themselves to get them right where they need to be at the most difficult of decisions.
It's a beautiful self-coaching process.
Yeah.
The idea of teaching you how to self-coach yourself in the long run, right?
But it's a hard conversation. But when yourself, your true self, is a stranger, you don't even know how to talk. We don't even know how to talk to ourselves. We say, we're stupid. We're so lazy. I can't believe we don't do this. Oh, I forgot again. I'm so dumb. I can't. Oh, I'm such a terrible whatever. That's the conversation we're having with ourselves. You wouldn't say that to a neighbor, a friend, anybody. Wouldn't talk. Just think of your self-talk. It's amazing how we talk to ourselves. But that goes back to, again, being awake and being aware of that conversation. So the idea is now authenticity. Who am I? Let's get to know this self, this me. So I can start creating the life I imagine. But we're afraid of me. We go back to fear. And then our risk management team up in the brain goes, oh, geez, nope. God, I don't want to open that door. We have a risk management team up there going, no, that's too scary. You better just sit this one out, right? You hear that? We know the noise. Where's that noise coming from? Right? And befriend that self. Be kind. I'm lovable. Now you're worthy of love. I'm being lovable. I'm being. What does that take, right? How do you do it? You express it differently than I do, than Ari does, than your husband or partner or whatever. But it's beautiful, it's unique, and it's you. and the world needs it. I mean it. You can't sit on it another day. So what action will you take tomorrow, today, tonight, to start making that change and getting to know your authentic self? No more limiting beliefs. What are you going to do that excites you? How are you going to change your emotional habits and patterns? How? These are the questions. Don't judge. Nobody's perfect. Nobody's perfect. We're not looking for perfection. We're looking for process. Right? How are you investing your time and your energy? Are you spending it? Are you wasting it? Are you investing it? And we're saying, I'm telling you, investing in you is the greatest, biggest investment you could ever make. Truly. Even as life coaches, this is what, again, we're accountability partners. As we say to people, you're investing in you. You're in this. This is your ride. I think someone asked Warren Buffett, like, you know, like, hey, Warren, you know, I think, you know, Warren, biggest, big billionaire or whatever, right? But, hey, Warren, what's the best investment you ever made? You know, is it IBM? You know, what's the thing? Oh, you know, all the best investment I ever made is myself.
Because everything else comes with it. When you invest with you, in you, and you shift your energy and you shift your thought process, and you can start living your life differently and happy and joyful, and everything we talked about tonight, not allowing someone else's words to make you feel negative, because no one makes you feel anything. You make yourself feel that way. Just remember that. Doesn't matter what anybody says to you, you still allow yourself the thought and you make yourself feel how you want to feel. Anyway, so Shawn, you're clearly making such a beautiful statement. And I wanted to add to that because.
Oh, jump in. This is, we're closing it up. I promise we're not going to go over an hour.
Yeah.
No, this is really good. I just want to say, first of all, I want to say thank you. And I want everyone to just, when you're done with this call, take a big, deep sense, breath of gratitude. Be grateful for what you do have. It's the best way to just get us back in alignment. What do I have?
Yeah.
What gifts?
Yeah.
I love it. The comments. And I want to say, please stay connected. We're building a nice community here, by the way, of people who want to be change makers in the world. Okay. You want to change your life. You want to grow. And it takes a community. Takes coaching and takes consistency. So keep showing up for yourself. And we're absolutely 100% here for each and every one of you as life coaches. You know how to get a hold of us, please. AlohaLifeCoaching.com. Boom, you can book sessions. We can talk, whatever it is. But no, invest in you. It's the most important decision you'll ever make.
Thank you so much, everybody, for joining us. And we'll see you at our next webinar for sure. And this one will be on the website if you want to watch it again sometime within the week.
Yes. You want to do one on sense of humor? I think you were onto something there. Having a wonderful sense of humor.
Oh, yes.
Perfect, but But don't lose that sense of humor. All right. As you discover yourself, don't take yourself that seriously sometimes, right? Be kind, loving, and be willing to laugh at yourself. For sure. Blessings.